In today's video, we'll be talking to you about how you can get your Turkish citizenship. There are two main ways. One is without investing any money, without investment, and the second is with investing. So let's first talk about without investing, right? So without investing, you can get your Turkish citizenship by living there for 5 years, right? Now, we have to be mindful that in this 5 years cannot just be on any sort of residence permit. It cannot be while you're a student, you're on a student residence permit, that doesn't count. If you are on a touristic residence permit that lots of people are on, just by renting a property, that does not work as well. So you need to either have a job, so you have a work permit, or you are a business owner, so you've got a business registration, or you have a property. So if you have, doesn't matter the amount of the property that you have, it's as long as you've got a property, that also counts. And if you registered your residence permit with those types, that allows you to actually get the Turkish citizenship after 5 years. Now again, we do need to also be mindful that for those 5 years, you can only be out of the country for 6 months. So let's say every year you decide to go out for a month, that's fine, that's just 5 months. So you have to actually be careful not to exceed that, otherwise your counter will start again and then you have to restart the process, right? So that is for without investment. Now let's talk about with investment. So with investment, basically, there are four main ways. The first one you've already heard of, which is the most common way, which is by investing $250,000 in a property, in a livable property, whether it's a villa, an apartment, you know, that is the first way. There are also three other ways, which I'll briefly just mention. So the second way is by investing $500,000 in a Turkish REIT fund, a real estate investment trust, or a Turkish venture capital fund. That's the second way. The other way is to deposit just money, like $500,000 for 3 years in a Turkish bank. And the last way is by employing 50 people. So you need to give jobs to 50 people. You have a business in Turkey, you're giving lots of jobs. That also qualifies you to get the Turkish citizenship. So let's go back to the first one, which is the most common one, which is by investment of $250,000 property investment in livable property, right? Let's talk about the concerns that come up. So question number one that comes up a lot is that, can I buy multiple properties or do I have to just buy one for that amount of money? The answer is yes. Yes, you can. You can buy more than one property. You can buy two, three, four, as much as you want, as long as you meet the minimum $250,000 requirement and you follow the procedures and you register those properties together at one time and you're actually following that set procedure outlined for the citizenship, right? So that's number one. Number two is, can I resell the property? And the answer is depends on when you want to resell it. If you're just gonna get the property, get the citizenship and then immediately resell, that is not allowed. So you do have to wait a certain period and that period is 3 years. You have to wait 3 years and then you can resell your property. How long does it take to get my citizenship? How long will it take? How long do I have to wait? So the fastest is around 2 months it takes, right? So from between 2 to 6 months, anywhere between 2 to 6 months, right? So depending on lots of cases at the time, depending on the offices, how they're functioning, their working hours and sort of the capacity. So based on that, it will take between 2 to 6 months. Now, let's talk about the advantages, right? So what are some of the advantages of having a Turkish passport? So the first advantage I'll talk about is travel. So you get visa-free access to 115 countries and privileged access to Schengen zone countries, the United States, United Kingdom, right? Canada, Australia, Japan, and South Korea. So you get privileged access to these countries as well. Number two is that you get a dual citizenship option. So if you have an existing passport that you want to keep, you don't want to give up your previous passport, that's totally fine with Turkey. They allow you to do that and you can keep your, you know, you can have a dual citizenship, right? Right, so that's number two. Number three is that families. So if your spouse and your children under 18 are also with you, so in that case, they will also be getting that citizenship as well. So you don't have to pay extra for your spouse, for your kids separately. So that is all falls under one family, immediate family it's considered. So your spouse and any kids under 18 are also can benefit from this citizenship scheme as well. Now any kids above the 18 years of age, so that's tough luck. You can just tell them, sorry, get your own 250K and you have to invest your own, to get your own citizenship, right? So that's for the family, right? So now, the other advantage is that you don't have to live in Turkey for the 5-year period we mentioned. So you can literally even apply, buy the properties remotely if you have to, and just even do the whole procedure remotely, yeah, through the Turkish embassy and so on, right? So of course we recommend you, obviously highly recommend you to actually come physically and do all those things. So that way you can make a better decision and make sure everything goes smoothly. Right, so that is highly recommended. The other thing is that you don't need to know the language. So the language requirement is, which is required actually, when you're doing it for the 5 years, you actually have to do the language test and the citizenship test. So those requirements are not here applicable. No language, no residency required, right? One more thing I really like is that for the Turkish citizenship, the scheme is that you don't have to donate any money to the government. You don't have to give up any money to the government. So all you're doing essentially is you're buying a property, and which you can resell that property down the line, right? So they're not like, you're buying a property at fair market fair value, which is the same as any Turks would pay. And then you can wait till it's, it rises in value, hopefully, inshallah, and then you can sell that property, right? So that is the very positive aspect when you compare it to some other countries that are offering citizenship schemes. So that is the other thing. Lastly, I want to also say that if you hold the property for, instead of reselling it, let's say you want to resell it after 3 years immediately, if you just hold it until 5 years, you don't pay any capital gains tax. So capital gains meaning, like, let's say you bought the property, let's say for a million Turkish liras, and after 5 years you're selling it, after 3 years let's say you're selling it for a 1.5 million, so you will have to pay capital gains tax on that 500,000 Turkish liras that you have profited. You will have to pay a considerable amount of capital gains. I believe it's around 30-35% you'll have to pay on that. So if you wait for 5 years, you don't pay any capital gains tax. So that is a huge advantage as well. Before we go, I just want to mention that definitely when you're going through the citizenship investment model, you have to make sure that you are speaking and you're working with a professional from the beginning. So you don't want to just go ahead and start buying properties on your own and then come to a lawyer or a professional agency and talk to them that, hey, I want to apply for citizenship. That it doesn't work like that. You have to get involved from the beginning. You can go ahead and choose your properties, that's fine, but you need to consult with the lawyers and professional agencies who have that knowledge, who will guide you through, make sure that the paper trail, the transfers, and the entire process is followed accordingly. Because for citizenship, it's a legal matter. So we need to make sure that all of these things are followed. So please make sure that if you're going for the citizenship, you keep that in mind and do speak to a professional before you go ahead and start buying properties. Thank you so much for watching the video. See you next time. Take care.